Hello students, today we are going to start most important and interesting lesson of our physics section, that is light, reflection and refraction. We all are familiar with light and its importance. Light is such an important source that without it all colorful things would have been black to us. There are number of wonderful phenomena associated with light, such as image formation by mirrors, twinkling of stars, beautiful rainbow and so on. In this lesson, we will study some phenomena related to light, such as reflection of light and refraction of light. These basic concepts will help us in study of optical phenomena in nature. In this lesson, you will understand reflection of light by spherical mirrors and refraction of light and their application in real life situation. So, let's start with what is light. We can define light as light is a form of energy that enables us to see around us. It is an electromagnetic wave that can travel through any medium as well as through vacuum. Students, we learn this in 9, that light is non-mechanical waves which do not require any medium for its propagation. So, we can define light as an electromagnetic wave which produces sensation of sight in our eyes. So, what is light? Light is an electromagnetic wave which produces the sensation of sight in our eyes. So, light is something which enables us to see everything present around us. For example, we can see variety of objects around us. But have you ever observed when we are in a dark room, we are unable to see anything. The moment you switch on the light, all things in the room become visible. What makes things visible? It is light which makes things visible. When light falls on the object, some of the light get reflected from its surface. That reflected light reaches our eyes and enables us to see the object. For example, if this is the object, light falls on the object and that light get reflect from the surface of the object. That reflected light enter in our eyes and it forms image of that object in our eyes and we can recognize that object. So, light is the form of energy which enables us to see the objects, to see the things present around us. There are two types of object, luminous object and non-luminous object. Luminous objects are those which have their own light. When their light reaches our eyes, we can see them. For example, sun, tube light, torch light, etc. It is not necessary that luminous objects should possess light naturally. If any substance glow on passing current or after heating, then that object, that substance also falls in the category of luminous objects. So, for example, this is sun. The light from sun enters in our eyes and we are able to see the sun or tube light or any luminous object, any object which possesses light. We can see it when the light enters from that object in our eyes. Second type of object is non-luminous objects. Those which do not have their own light. If there is no light, we can't see such objects. For example, in dark room, we were unable to see all the things such as furniture, walls in that room. If we switch on the light, then we can see these things. or during day, due to sunlight, we are able to see all these things, because light from the source, such as light from tubes or light from sun, falls on those object, it get reflected, and that reflected light reach to our eyes and forms image and enable us to see the object. Now we will discuss some basic properties of light. See, just now we discussed that light is a form of energy that travels in the form of waves. Light is an electromagnetic waves. So light waves are electromagnetic waves which do not require any medium for its propagation, and so it is also known as non-mechanical waves. Speed of light in vacuum is 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second. It is high speed of light. When light travels through a transparent medium, its speed decreases. This decrease in speed depends upon the type of medium. So, as I told, 3 into 10 raised to 8 meters per second is the speed of light in vacuum. As light enters in any other medium, such as in air, in water, its speed decreases depending on the optical density of that medium. Length of visible light ranges from 4 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter to 8 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter. See, visible light is the segment of electromagnetic waves that the human eye can view. So, this segment, that is 4 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter to 8 into 10 raised to minus 7 meter, these waves, these electromagnetic waves are visible to human eyes. We can see the objects, we can see the light if it is in this particular range. And so, this range of electromagnetic wave is called as visible light or visible range of light. Human eye can detect wavelength from 380 nanometer to 700 nanometer. So, this is the range in which the human eye can detect the light, and so it is called as visible light or visible range of electromagnetic radiation. Wavelength of light is very small as compared to normal size of object. In such a situation, light waves can be considered to travel from one point to another on a straight line path joining them. So, we can consider that light travels by joining one point to another in a straight line. And this straight line path joining one point to another in the direction of propagation of light is known as ray of light. So, this is ray of light. And group of such rays of light is known as beam of light. So, this group of ray of light is called as beam of light, and single straight line path of light is called as ray of light. When ray of light is incident on a surface, then these phenomena can take place, and those are reflection, refraction and absorption. See, either reflection of light will take place if light incident on any object, or refraction or transmission of light and absorption of light can take place. See, first one, reflection. When light falling on a surface may strike the surface and bounce back, this striking and bouncing back of light ray is called as reflection. We can see in this diagram. Here, this line is the boundary separating two different media. When light, this incident ray is the light which falls on this surface, it strikes this surface and bounce back in the same medium. And this is called the striking and bouncing back of light ray is called as reflection. It takes place mostly for a completely polished, shining or plain surface like mirror. Next is refraction. When light falls on a surface, it may pass through it. Certain substances allow rays of light to pass, and few substances allow only certain rays to pass. Those substances allow all rays pass appear to be transparent. So the substances from which all rays pass, those substances appear as transparent substances. For example, plain glass, that is what transparent, because when light falls on it, all the rays of light pass through it, and this process of transmitting, allowing rays to pass through it, is called as transmit process or transmission of light. As I told, example is glass or water. On transparent medium, refraction of light takes place, that is bending of light as it enters from one medium to another transparent medium. Here we can observe refraction of light. This is the incident ray which strikes on the surface of this medium, which is separating two mediums, that is air medium and water medium. As this ray of light enters in the water medium, it bends in the water medium, its speed changes, and this phenomena is called as refraction of light. Next is absorption. When light falls on a surface, it may get absorbed. The surface that absorbs all the light falling on it appears to be black in color. So these are the three phenomena which can take place when light falls on any surface. Either that light will get reflect if that surface is plain, polished or smooth surface, or if the surface is transparent, then transmission of light will take place or refraction of light will take place. And on some surfaces, when light falls, it will get absorbed, and that object, that surface will appear black in color. So all these are basic properties of light, which will help you to understand reflection and refraction of light. Now let's start with first phenomena of light, that is reflection of light. Reflection of light is the bouncing back of light rays on striking the surface. For example, if this is one surface, and when ray of light get incident on this surface, it will bounce back. If the ray of light is not able to pass through the surface, then it will bounce back in the same medium, and this striking and bouncing back of light is called as reflection of light. We can observe this in this diagram also. See, here this is the incident ray. This ray strike on this surface at this point of incidence, and this incident ray or ray of light bounce back in the same medium, that is in the air medium, and this phenomena of striking and bouncing back is called as reflection of light. To show reflection, there are certain characteristics, such as that surface should be shiny, smooth and polished. Out of all different surfaces, silver metal is considered as a best reflector because it is shiny, smooth and it is polished surface, which helps in the reflection of light. Here are some terminology involved in case of reflection. These terms will help you to understand the reflection. See, incident ray. It is the ray that strikes the surface. For example, this is the surface, smooth polished surface. The incident ray is the ray that strikes the surface. So this ray which strikes this surface is called as incident ray. Next is point of incidence. The point at which the incident ray strikes the surface is called as point of incidence. So this is the point of incidence on which this incident ray strikes this particular surface. Reflected ray, the ray that bounces back on striking the surface. This is the reflected ray, which bounces back in the same medium on striking the surface. Normal ray, it is an imaginary line or the line which is perpendicular to the surface, which makes the 90 degree angle with the surface, is called as normal drawn. So these are some basic terms, important terms which help you to understand reflection. So incident ray is denoted by I, reflected ray is denoted by small r, normal is the perpendicular drawn to the surface, point of incidence the point at which the ray strikes to the surface. Now we will discuss about the types of reflection. There are two types of reflection, regular reflection and irregular reflection. Regular reflection is when a parallel beam of light is incident on a smooth shining plane surface. The beam remains parallel after reflection in a specific direction. Such reflection is called as regular reflection. We can see here in this diagram. Here, this is the diagram of regular reflection. In this, the parallel beam of light is what? The group or bunch of rays of light. These rays of light incident parallel on the surface, and after reflection they remains parallel, and such type of reflection is called as regular reflection. Another one is irregular reflection. Irregular reflection is when a parallel beam of light is incident on rough and irregular surface. The beam of light does not remain parallel but spreads over wide area after reflection. We can see in this diagram the rays or the beam of light, it is parallel, but after reflection the reflected rays does not remain parallel to each other. They spread all over the wide region. They spread all over the place, and such type of reflection is called as irregular reflection. Regular reflection takes place on smooth, shiny, polished surface, and irregular reflection takes place on rough or irregular surface. I hope you understood the types of reflection, that is regular reflection and irregular reflection. Students, you are familiar with the laws of reflection of light. We learn this in 9th class. Let us recall the laws. Laws of reflection states that angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. And the second statement is the incident ray, reflected ray and the normal to the reflecting surface at the point of incidence lie in the same plane. Just now we discuss about incident ray, reflected ray, point of incidence and normal. So here we can see this is incident ray, this is the plane surface, it is a mirror, and this one is the point of incidence. This perpendicular drawn to the surface is the normal. First statement of laws of reflection state that angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is the angle between incident ray and the normal. So this is angle of incidence, which is made between incident ray and the normal. Angle of refraction is the angle made between reflected ray and the normal. It is denoted by small r. According to law of reflection, I is equal to R, or angle of incidence is equal to angle of refraction. Second statement states that incident ray, reflected ray and the normal to the reflecting surface lie in the same plane. We can see here incident ray, normal and reflected ray all are there in the same plane. So this is the laws of reflection of light. Students, these laws of reflection are applicable to all types of reflecting surface, such as plane surface, spherical surface, or it is applicable to regular or irregular surfaces. A ray of light which is incident normally on a mirror is reflected back along its own path. Means when the ray of light is incident normally like this, then this will get reflected along the same path. And in this case, I is equal to angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection is equal to 0. So keep this in mind, if the ray of light is incident normally, then angle of incidence and angle of reflection is 0. Now we will learn about formation of image by plane mirror. But before that, we will discuss about types of mirror and types of images. See, types of mirrors. There are two types of mirror, plane mirror and spherical mirror. Plane mirrors are those that have plane reflecting surface. For example, the mirror which we are using every day for grooming, for dress up, that mirror is plane mirror, which is smooth, which is shiny and which is polished from one side. Spherical mirrors are the other types that have a curved reflecting surface. They are generally of two types, that is one with bulge and other with depression. The bulge one is convex mirror, and on the one with depression is concave mirror. See, if this is plane mirror which we use every day, this particular side is non-reflecting surface and this side is reflecting surface. Then spherical mirrors are either convex or concave. Convex means the bulge side is the reflecting one. So here, if this is the mirror, this bulge side is the reflecting surface. From this surface light get reflect, and this particular surface is non-reflecting surface. Such type of mirror is called as convex mirror. Concave mirror means the mirror which is having depression. So in this mirror, the depressed side is the reflecting surface. Such mirror is called as concave mirror. Next is types of images. An image is formed when the reflected rays actually meet or appear to meet at a certain point. So whenever the image is formed, means what? The light rays will fall on the object, it will get reflect from that object, that reflected ray will meet at certain point or it will appear to meet at certain point, and that second point, that another point is the image of that particular object. Accordingly, two types of images are formed depending on whether the reflected rays meet or not. Those are real image and virtual image. Real image, it is that which is formed when reflected rays actually meet at a certain point. It is always inverted and can be obtained on screen. Another type of image is virtual image. It is that which is formed when reflected rays do not meet actually but appear to meet at a certain point. Virtual image is always erect and it can't be obtained on a screen. So there are two types of images based on the reflected rays are meet with each other or appear to meet with each other at certain point. Now we will discuss about the plane mirror and the image formed by plane mirror. In this diagram, you can see this is the plane mirror. Object AB is placed in front of mirror. The light get incident on the mirror, which is a flat surface, flat reflecting surface. After incident, the light get reflected, and those reflected rays do not intersect, do not meet each other in front of mirror. But when we extend the reflected rays, so this one is the reflected ray, when we extend these reflected ray behind the mirror, these rays appear to meet each other and forms the image of object that is A dash B dash. So in case of plane mirror, the image which is formed is virtual and erect, because we know virtual image reflected in virtual image, the reflected rays do not intersect, do not meet each other, it appears to meet each other. So in plane mirror, virtual and erect image is formed. This type of image do not form on the screen, but as we learn, real images can be recorded on the screen. Then the image is equal to that of object, or the size of image is same as size of object in case of plane mirror. The image formed is far behind the mirror as object is in front of mirror. We can see here object AB is placed in front of mirror and we obtained the image behind the mirror. So in case of plane mirror, the nature of image is what? It is virtual and erect. The size is same that of object and image is formed behind the mirror at the same distance from the object or from the mirror. Means if the distance between object and mirror is 2 cm, then the distance between image and the mirror is also 2 cm. So in case of plane mirror, size of image is same and distance of image and distance of object is same from the mirror. So if the object is 2 cm from the mirror, then image will also form at 2 cm from the mirror. And the image is laterally inverted. Means what? In front of mirror, if we will raise our left hand, it will appear as right hand of our image. The left side of object appear on right side of image, and such type of image is called as laterally inverted image. Plane mirror is commonly used as looking glass, which we use every day for grooming, and is also used in making periscope for observing over, around or through an obstacle or object. It is used by sailors, used in submarines to see what is going on the water surface. Plane mirror is also used in kaleidoscope. Students, I hope you understood all the basic terms related to light and properties of light and reflection of light. In next video, we will learn about spherical mirrors. Thank you and have a nice day.